Hey guys, welcome to Indie Game Hustle. In this UModeler video, we're going to take a quick look at the Boolean tool. Alright, so in this scene here, I have about three different objects. And just keep in mind, each one of these objects were created using a UModeler shape primitive, right? So this is pretty much the box tool, and this is the sphere. Alright, so if you would like to use the Boolean method to get any particular shapes or create additional shapes, it's actually pretty good. I find that their Boolean operation is done very well. So for instance, we have this box here and we want to subtract this box from this mesh. The first thing you want to do is select the mesh that you want it to carve out of, or you want to select this mesh. In this mesh, we want it to carve out of this mesh. So I'm going to select this one. Now that I've had these two selected, if you notice on the right side, it's only going to show us the particular options that are available to us. So the first one is going to be in this section, which is called the add section. And you're going to have the Boolean union tool. We have the Boolean subtract. We have the intersect. And those are the only Booleans. This is a mirror object. We're going to deal with that later. All right. So for the first one, Boolean union, so I'm going to click this. Now, what this is going to do is going to merge them together. So now they're technically just one object. Typically, that's what we would expect when you Boolean and just merge two objects together. All right, so let me Control Z out of that. All right, so the one that we want to do is this one here. We want to subtract this from this, right? So you have to select this one first, then this one, then hit this key here. Boom. And so now we've actually subtracted the first selected mesh from this object. All right, I'm gonna get out of there. And now we're back to standard. All right, so the next one is gonna be the intersect. So the intersection between these two objects. So for instance, at this point, it's going to leave whatever's in between here. So if I hit that, as you notice, it's going to leave the intersect. I very rarely use this one at all, but I mean, it's there. So if you want to use it, go for it. All right. And the same thing can be done with the sphere. So if you have a sphere and we want to subtract this sphere from this particular cube, we select the sphere first, then this one, and then hit this button and we do a subtraction there. And so that's really nice. So if you are trying to make any particular design or layout, that's one way to approach it, right? Let's see here. So if we want to subtract from this and then take this one and subtract from this, and then now you have, it has that applied to both. So that's pretty much the Boolean in a nutshell. The Boolean is kind of, I wouldn't call it experimental. It is a feature, it is a tool to use, but just be mindful. Some things can break. So if you have like a Boolean that has maybe like too many polygons, or if, for instance, you may bring in a object, so I'll show you that right quick. If, for instance, we went to game object and did a 3D object and did a sphere, right? And I'm gonna actually delete the UModeler sphere and use this sphere here. So for instance, what we can do is, first thing, in order to use this sphere, we have to convert this object to a UModeler object. So there's this icon here called UModelerize. And what we do is click that, and it turns it into a object where we can actually now manipulate the faces, right? So as it stands right now, the way it is, if we were to take this object and then select this and then do the same operation we did before, it's going to take a little bit of time. I'm not sure what's going on behind the scenes, but I believe last time I tried this, it broke. So there you have it. So it did do it, but there's some other issues going on with this object, right? And so just keep in mind that that doesn't always work. There's probably some workarounds to that. What I first could do is maybe, and if I was just taking some little time during this to do, let's see here. What I can do is maybe merge these faces together. Not sure, but I think that for the most part is the type of downsides to it. So I would recommend if you're going to use the Boolean tool, I would say stick with using it with another UModeler object. All right. Well, other than that, that's the Boolean tool. Have fun. I think it's a really good tool. I think it works extremely well. Just have fun with it. I'd love to see what you guys do with your tools. All right. See you next video. Bye.